What's up, guys? Tim here from Everyday Tactical Vids, and I'm actually in my backyard just hanging out, and I wanted to make this short video about fire starters. A lot of people talk about different ways to get your fire started, and some of them are very basic, but if you've never actually tried it, then it's just theory and you gotta actually get out there and practice those skills. So what you're gonna see is that classic thing that a lot of people know about for starting fires, which is lint. Some people take cotton balls and soak them in Vaseline or put Vaseline on them and then have them stored for starting fires. But dryer lint is cheap. It's available everywhere pretty much, obviously, in your dryer. And if you store it up real nice and compacted, and then when you get to start your fire out in the woods, fluff it up, put a spark to it, it'll start very quickly. So I want to show you two things. First, how it doesn't start when it's super compacted, but then also how it does once it is fluffed up. All right, let's check it out. Okay, here is some dryer lint that has not been fluffed up, so it will catch fire, but watch how much more slowly it burns compared to the second one. So let's just hit this with a spark. So smoldering a little bit there. Still smoldering. There you go, eventually. That's quite a slow burn, obviously. So let me get this out of the way. And then, look at this, we got some dryer lint here. I'm just gonna fluff this up and watch how much more quickly it actually gets going. Obviously, this is all about surface area, and you gotta have oxygen when you're dealing with making fire. So, much more fluffed up, and watch this. One shot. So dryer lint definitely works. You can, you know, get it for free basically. Keep it nice and compact when you're putting it in your bag, but then once you get to ready to go, fluff it up and you've got a great fire starter. All right, thanks for checking out the video, guys. Take care.